Space is full of incredible and mind-blowing mysteries. Here are 10 of the most insane discoveries ever made. When we think of space, it can often invoke thoughts of a space completely devoid of life, just an empty and desolate place. But astronomers have found that there can be unexpected things waiting to surprise us in unlikely places. Take Saturn's largest moon, Titan. Its surface is covered with massive canyons that are cut up to half a mile deep into the moon's crust. Imagine it like a massive version of the Grand Canyon. These geographic features have been known by astronomers for a long time. But for the first time, astronomers were able to detect veins of this canyon filled with liquid hydrocarbons. Finding liquid on another planetary body is always exciting for astronomers, as it can unlock mysteries and hint at what has happened in the past. Could erosion caused by this liquid be responsible for carving these massive canyons that spiderweb across Titan's surface? Or is the source fluid long gone and these hydrocarbons are the results of something more extraterrestrial? Have you ever been flying in a plane and had to go through a particularly rough patch of turbulence? It can be a terrifying experience that can throw you off air travel when it's bad enough. Now, you might think this issue would easily be avoided when traveling through the vacuum of space. But just because there is no air in space to cause turbulence, there are other sources of interference that can affect those traveling through the cosmos. NASA scientists have now detected events that are sending electromagnetic energy out through space, causing magnetic turbulence that can have effects on all types of technologies and even the bodies of astronauts. This type of turbulence is still not entirely understood, and the effects it causes may be more severe than scientists currently believe. While surveying the sky and looking for evidence of dark energy, a graduate student found an object that, with the help of his advisor, turned out to be a fantastic find. They had just stumbled upon the largest comet ever found. Comets are big hunks of frozen gases and rock that spend their time in orbit around our Sun, releasing some material into a long tail as they heat up. This massive rock measures more than 10 times wider than the average comet, reaching nearly 130 kilometers, and is 1,000 times more massive than the typical comet scientists have found flying through our solar system. To add to the amazement of this discovery, scientists have now figured out that the last time this comet visited us, our ancient hominid ancestors walked the surface of the Earth around 3 million years ago, meaning the famous Australopithecus found in Ethiopia, Lucy, may have seen this comet blazing across the sky while looking to the stars. Now named after its discoverers, the Bernardellini-Bernstein comet will make its approach towards the Sun in just under a decade, which will give astronomers their best chance at studying this behemoth of a space rock. Space is often depicted as a cold and harsh place to be. But until the Royal Astronomical Society started to look through the remnants of radiation from the Big Bang, scientists didn't realize how cold it could get. While focusing their instruments on one small corner of the universe, they found that it was much colder and far more empty than the rest of the universe. Referred to as the WMAP cold spot, this minute region of the universe is 140 degrees microkelvin colder than the rest of the cosmic microwave background radiation, also called CMB radiation, found throughout space, which is a significant difference. One of the most popular theories explaining what is going on here contends that there is a massive void sitting in between us and the primordial CMB, which can influence the readings scientists to take, leading to the appearance of the cold spot. Other theories can get a bit more imaginative in dealing with parallel universes, imprinting their shadow on our universe through some weird workings of quantum entanglement. Our Sun, the center of our solar system and the source of the heat that keeps our planet warm enough to sustain life. In the last few years, scientists have seen the Sun become much quieter and has been thought to be going through a still more dormant period with very little activity across its surface. But now that nap seems to be over, as our Sun is beginning to wake up and has experienced powerful eruptions across its corona. Not only have sunspots and solar flares been coming more often, but they have also been a bit larger than in the past few years. These events are spewing colossal amounts of energetical charged particles out into the solar system and towards our planet. If these particles and energizes strike the Earth, they could cause massive disruptions for our satellites and communications. Luckily for us, our planet is surrounded by a powerful magnetic field generated through its hot iron core. This magnetic field protects us from the brunt of these solar emissions, but scientists still need to be prepared just in case there is an event powerful enough to overcome our magnetic shield. A new study looking into the formation of planets has found evidence for their theory that planets begin to form as golf ball-sized clumps of matter within clouds of dust and debris. These clumps then continue to build, forming tiny planets that scientists refer to as planetesimals. Researchers found their most convincing evidence when studying two ancient meteorites that had formed during the pre-planetary time of our solar system and had remained unaltered after crashing to the Earth long ago. After cutting into these meteorites, scientists found golf ball-sized clumps of matter dispersed throughout its material. These might be some of the first planetesimals to have formed in our solar system. Typically, these clumps of matter will continue to grow larger and larger, feeding off of the matter and dust clouds that orbit around them. Eventually, after growing to a certain size, a new planet is formed that will live out its life orbiting its home star. If astronomers can get their hands on more physical evidence for these golf ball-sized planet-building clumps, they hope to use them to understand more about what is present when planets form and how that can eventually lead to the emergence of life. Astronomers have already found thousands of planets within the Milky Way, but a new study based on a state-of-the-art simulation has just revealed that there may be a mind-blowing number of Earth-like planets in our galaxy. Based on data gathered from the Kepler Space Telescope on its hunt for exoplanets, this new study is predicting as many as 6 billion Earth-like planets in the Milky Way. That means that one out of every 5 Sun-like stars in our galaxy likely has at least one Earth-like planet. If there are that many planets in the Milky Way galaxy that match our own, could there be intelligent life on some of them? It seems exceedingly unlikely that only one out of 6 billion planets were able to harbor life and nurture it as it evolves over the years. Deep in the Milky Way, around 1300 light years away from Earth, astronomers made a fascinating and possible life-altering discovery in the Iris Nebula. While studying this nebula, they were looking for a particular type of molecule called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons that make up nearly 10% of all carbon in the universe. This type of carbon is believed to be essential to the origin of life, as it can be released when burning organic material. Before the team made their readings, they theorized that the intense radiation coming from the central star should cause the molecules within the nebula to degrade. In this nebula, however, radiation from its central star seems to strike these special hydrocarbons, which cause them to merge with others into larger and more complex molecules. The team of astronomers studying this nebula recently published a paper in the journal Astronomy and Astrophysics, which dove into their findings, showing that, as predicted, the smaller molecules were destroyed by the harsh radiation present. But in this discovery, they saw the radiation cause medium-sized molecules to combine into larger molecules. Could this be the process that created the material that kick-started the emergence of life on Earth? We think of planets as round balls of matter floating out in space, partly because this has been true for all of the planets we have been able to spot. But some scientists have begun to see a new shape of planet pop up in their models of the universe. In very specific gravitational situations, a planet may form into a donut shape called a toroid in the very early stages of its formation. This newly theorized planetary shape is called a cenestia. Within the group of scientists studying cenestias, some researchers believe that the Earth may have even taken this form in the very beginning, which could also answer the question as to the origins of the Moon. The Earth and the Moon are chemically very similar, with only some minute differences lending evidence to the theory. There are several ways in which a cenestia can form, including when the collision between two planetary bodies results in a mass of rapid spinning molten rock. But this state is rather short-lived, perhaps only lasting for a few hundred years, which is just a blink of an eye in the timescale of planets. There may be no way to prove that this is truly how our planet and moon were formed, but there is a momentum building behind this idea. We are all aware of the James Webb Space Telescope and its newly released pictures that show off its incredible array of features. But there is still much work to be done, studying the newly received data coming from this telescope to uncover all of the wonders they contain. One of these insane discoveries was the imaging of a new galaxy, Glass Z13, which sits at an insane distance of 33.205 light-years away from us. This galaxy is so far away that Webb's image shows it as it was only 300 million years after the Big Bang, making it the earliest galaxy to ever be found. What changes might the galaxy have gone through in the 14.4 billion years since this light began its journey to us? And while the galaxy is extremely small, about 100 times smaller than our own Milky Way, there is an incredibly fast rate of star formation, with a total stellar weight of around 1 billion suns, leading scientists to theorize that the environment of the early universe may be more different than we imagine it. Luckily for us, this is only the first attempt to use Webb's power to look deep into the past of our universe, and this galaxy only represents the beginning of what will be found. Thanks for watching. What insane space discovery did we miss that gets you excited? See you next time on Matter.